the curtain stabber. Two men who would drink regularly together between the two villages of Blibora and Curtain. Just before Christmas 1847, the two men were walking through a field. One of the men, Charles Copeman, was to be soon married, and Joe Travis, who was struggling financially, stabbed his friend Charles for a few pieces of silver. The lanes back then and even today are dark. The area between Curtain and the A15, also known as the Old Roman Road, have always been superstitious to the locals, with many deaths that have occurred over the centuries. The two men were walking from the Greyhound in Blibora to the Red Lion in Curtain, with Charles' dog. It was the next day when Charles' body was found with knife wounds on his head and face as well as his throat cut, with the dog still with Charles' body. Joe's knife was still at the crime scene too. When Joe Travis went to Lincoln for the trial, which Joe would have been hanged for sure, Joe also explained that it had been forgotten a knife was in hand when punching Charles, and only reason a knife was in hand, so could cut the chip of a cigar. Joe got acquitted of Charles' murder due to no clothes being found, due to the blood loss from Charles after having the jugular cut. People who became skeptical of where the clothes could have been. Some people thought that Joe's mother wore the clothes under her own during the investigation, or the clothes were burnt. Unbeknownst to Joe, there was a witness on the night of the fatal stabbing, although Joe did not know this until one night when Joe was drinking in the George Inn at Curtain, when a man named Robert Fell spoke out so every patron could hear, "I could have been rewarded £400. Robert had a disagreement with his wife, and decided to go for a walk. That's how he managed to witness the murder taking place. The records don't show why Robert did not be a witness in testimony, only those can speculate. One of those speculations is that Robert also had a hand in the murder. Joe could not be trial for murder again, instead Joe was tried for robbery. This time Joe was sentenced for the crime, although was not by hanging. Joe was set to be transported to Australia. Joe never made it to land again. Not long into the journey Joe died.